be filled here at this table, food for all who hunger, and drink for all who thirst. Drink of his love, wine of salvation, you shall live forever in Jesus Christ the Lord. You who labor for justice, you who labor for peace, you who steady the plow in the field of the Lord, come and be filled here at this table, food for all who hunger, and drink for all who thirst. Drink of his love, wine of salvation, you shall live forever in Jesus Christ the Lord.
Good evening. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Yes, my dear friends, today's readings very clearly explains that when the Spirit of the Lord is with us, we should live a life which is pleasing to God. That means an inclusive way of life. Let us appreciate the good works that is done by others. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins to prepare to celebrate this holy sacrament. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I am guilty of sin in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy. Glory, glory, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you. We glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, glory, glory, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the take away the sins of the world, have mercy.
mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory, glory, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father, glory, glory, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hasting to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord came down in the cloud and spoke to Moses, taking some of the spirit that was on Moses. The Lord bestowed it on the 70 elders. And as the spirit came to rest on them, they prophesied. Now two men, one named Elad and the other Medad, were not in the gathering, but had been left in the camp. They too had been on the list, but had not gone out to the tent. Yet the Spirit came to rest on them also, and they prophesied in the camp. So when a young man quickly told Moses, Eldad and Medad are prophesying in the camp. Joshua, son of Nun, who from his youth had been Moses' aide, said, "Moses, my Lord, stop them." But Moses answered him, "Are you jealous for my sake? Would that all the people of the Lord were prophets? Would that the Lord might bestow his spirit on them all." The word of the Lord.
Precepts of the Lord give joy to the
the heart.
The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The decree of the Lord is trustworthy, giving wisdom to the simple.
The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinances of the Lord are true, all of them just.
The precepts of the
servant is careful of them, very diligent in keeping them, yet who can detect failings? Cleanse me from my unknown faults.
Precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
From wanton sin especially restrain your servant. Let it not rule over me. Then shall I be blameless and innocent of serious sin.
The precepts of the Lord give joy to the
A reading from the letter of St. James. Come now, you rich, weep and wail over your impending miseries. Your wealth has rotted away. Your clothes have become moth-eaten. Your gold and silver corroded. And that corrosion will be a testimony against you. You have stored up treasure for the last days. Behold, the wages you withheld from the workers who harvested your fields are crying aloud. And the cries of the harvesters have reached the ears of the Lord of hosts. You have lived on earth in luxury and pleasure. You have fattened your hearts for the day of slaughter. You have condemned, you have murdered the righteous one. He offers you no resistance. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
His truth. Consecrate us in the truth.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. At that time, John said to Jesus, "Teacher, we saw someone driving out demons in your name, and we tried to prevent him because he does not follow us." Jesus replied, "Do not prevent him. There is no one who performs a mighty deed in my name who can at the same time speak ill of me. For whoever is not against us is for us. Anyone who gives you a cup of water to drink because you belong to Christ, amen, I say to you, will surely not lose his reward. Whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it would be better for him if a great millstone were put around his neck and he were thrown into the sea. If your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life maimed than with two hands to go into Gehenna, into the unquenchable fire. If your foot causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life crippled than with 2 feet to be thrown into Gehenna. And if your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out. Better for you to enter the kingdom of God with one eye than with 2 eyes be thrown into Gehenna, where their worm does not die and the fire is not quenched." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus replied, "Do not prevent him. There is no one who performs a mighty deed in my name who can at the same time speak ill of me. But a brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus." And last Sunday, we have seen an argument and discussion among the disciples, that is, who is great among themselves? In another word, who is greatest in the sight of God? And the readings very clearly explain to us, that is, one who seeks the God's wisdom and lives according to the God's plan. At the same time, one who has the humility, service, and simplicity. And also from the gospel very clearly explain that we should not have jealousy and selfish ambition and envy with us. Yes, my dear friends, and today, in the life of Joshua and John, and we come to know very clearly that we should not have jealousy and intolerance, and we should respect and appreciate one another. How it is possible? And God also says today that we should take away the jealousy feeling from our heart and from our family, and asking us to encourage and appreciate one another. The first reading very clearly says that God's Spirit rests on Eldad and the Medad, even though they were not at the gathering. And this surprises everyone, including Moses. And Moses explains that God can choose anyone to share his Spirit. God can choose anyone to share his spirit. Yes, my dear friends, the first reading very clearly teaching us today, God's spirit is not limited. It's not a private property of anyone. And God's spirit is larger than anything, and his grace is everywhere. Yes, my dear friends, God's spirit is with you, with your family members and neighbors. God's grace is with you, with your neighbors, with me, and everywhere. And says very clearly, it is not a private property. He is with everyone. Yes, my dear friends, that's why very clearly says that God can work through anyone regardless of where they are. But we should have an open heart to see the God's work in unexpected places and people. Yes, my dear friends, through the first reading, God is asking you and me, we should become more inclusive way of life or thinking, because God's spirit works with everyone, not only with me, not only with you, even through our neighbors who does the good. That's why we see in the gospel very clearly, when the disciples see someone casting out the demons in Jesus' name, and they were trying to stop him, but Jesus tells them not to stop him, because anyone who is not against us is for us. Yes, my dear friends, Jesus emphasizes that good works done in his name are valuable. This lesson shows that the importance of being inclusive in our ministry. We should not be quick in judge others who are doing good works. The best word today, we should not judge the others. We should not quick judge the others and their works, even if they are not part of our group. And Jesus is asking you and me, we should focus on our own faithfulness, because Jesus values all our efforts done in his name. When the Spirit of the Lord is with us, when we are doing the ministry, and when you are working for God's glory, we should not judge the others. We should focus on our faithfulness and our way of life and our relationship with God and about the blessings. Yes, my dear friends, a person who sees God's glory in all the good works would not feel jealousy and intolerance, but real joy, because all good works bring glory to God. Yes, my dear friends, by appreciating the good works of others, we build a strong community. We are all working towards the same goal. The spirit of inclusiveness strengthens our faith and unity. That's why, very clearly, in the second reading, St. James tells to you and to me that there is a danger being a greedy. That is, wealth can make us selfish and blind to the needs of others. Wealth can make us selfish and blind to the needs of others. True wealth is found in sharing and caring for those less fortunate. Yes, my dear friends, once again, Jesus teaches through the second reading that we are all called to be generous and just. We are all called to be generous and just and use our wealth, our resources wisely. Yes, my dear friends, we are all called, invited today to see God's Spirit in unexpected places, and we are all invited to use our wealth justly and appreciate the good works of others. We are all invited to embrace God's grace and avoid jealousy and intolerance in our life. God bless us all. Amen. Please stand for creed. I believe in one God. Gathered as the family, united in faith and baptism, let us bring our needs and prayers before our loving God and Father.
For the Pope and all who shepherd in the Church in Christ's name, may the Lord bestow his Spirit on them ever more fully. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For world leaders, may God be their guide in their efforts to bring peace to the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who struggle to put their trust in God, may they be given grace to see his love and goodness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those gathered here, may we be bound ever more closely to Christ, especially through the mysteries celebrated in this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who have died in faith, especially Elizabeth Antel, Neil Akoba, Barbara C. Jager, and Sally G. Valentine, may Jesus, the Lamb of God, welcome them into the eternal kingdom of the Father. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. Let us pray for the people, those asked our prayers, and the sick and suffering. The Lord may bless them abundantly. For this we pray to you, Lord. Lord, our loving Father, today is said to us that take away the jealousy and intolerance from your mind and have the mind of appreciating the good works of others. Thank you, Lord, for strengthening and guiding us. Help us to remain always in love. Help us to build the kingdom of God in our lives, in the family, and in the community. For this, we pray to you, Lord. Let us pray for personal needs in silence. God of mercy and justice, hear our prayers. We ask through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Turn to me, O turn and be saved, says the Lord, for I am God. There is no other, none beside me. You, who are you to be afraid? A flesh that fades is made like the grass of the field, soon to wither. Turn to me, O turn and be saved, says the Lord, for I am God. There is no other, none beside me. I call your
Pray, brother and sister, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifices to your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for the glory and good of all his holy Church.
Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of the blessing may be laid open before us through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness, that is ours. He humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. And by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so, with angels and archangels, with the thrones and dominions, and with all the host and the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, your pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. You have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and the blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, our spouse, with your blessed apostles and the glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, and whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of the world. Be pleased to conform in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Pope Francis, Bishop Myron, the order of the bishops, and all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take us.
the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace, grant us peace, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life, say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust.
And he will raise you up
angels' wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The seraph, the fowler, will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings, your refuge, his faithfulness, your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. You need not fear the shadow of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day. The thousands fall about you, near you it shall not come, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. For to his angels he's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against the stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand, and hold you, hold you in the palm of his hand.
Remember your word to your servant, O Lord, by which you have given me hope. This is my comfort when I am brought low. Let us pray. May these heavenly mysteries, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be cohesed in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united. Whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
This Friday, October 4th, we will be celebrating the Feast of St. Francis. All pet owners are invited to bring their pets to the grass area in front of the church at 8:15 for a special blessing. The Knights of Columbus and Legion of Mary invite all parish families to our monthly chaplet of Divine Mercy and Family Rosary to be held this Sunday, September 29th at 3 o'clock p.m. in the church. Join us Thursday, October 3rd from 6 o'clock to 7:30 p.m. in the church for St. Anthony's Ministry of Healing. For more information on these announcements, please see our parish bulletin and website.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Have a blessed day.
Thank you, Father.
Awake from your slumber, arise from your sleep. A new day is dawning for all those who weep. The people in darkness have seen a great light. The Lord of our longing has conquered the night. Let us build the city of God. May our tears be turned into dancing. For the Lord, our light and our love, has turned the night into day.